aggressive. Venomance, if you run at him, he just pops the poison over and gets everyone down nice and low, so.
Yeah.
Okay, Ghost will be the one to pick up the Faceless Void. Yeah, and they will try and man up on Tide down bottom. Lead C to start things off. There's your Venomous Gale. They do have a tether. This very well could be your first blood. That double slow is just so potent. Nowhere for the Tide to run. Oh! Will they let him get away? Okay, the poison takes him down. Not joining invasion right now. An arrow will actually smoke up around the backside. Johnny looking to initiate with the shackles. He does actually have 3 points in the Ether Shock here. And there you go. Shackles come out on the ADTR. Now the poison over flies. Where is the real action going to break out? Ghost hops forward right onto Johnny. Wisp has already gone down. It's a 1-for-1 trade to get things started. But then they lose the Venom. And now Arrow off to a pretty good start in this fight. Tide joining the battle. Throws out a Gush onto Ghost. And even a Rabbit. That secures the kill.
Your BKB and the crit for a little bit of damage. We'll see what trajectory he follows. Mid lane taking some pressure, but Snow could be in trouble here. Tide does have a Ravage available on the high ground. There's Mosin. And there will be a Poison Nova coming out from the Venom. The up 14 completely obliterated. Invoker that gets that kill. Wisp gets picked off as well. The turns here from Ghost comes out. There's your Ravage. And not enough to keep the Aegis alive, but they do secure the kill onto the Faceless Void. BKB, Popeye, Ketchik, and he will try to keep you out, but will be
even Alacrity on these Necro 3 units. It's going to be pretty scary. Void hopping forward, though. There's a Chronosphere out, and Lance is actually in the front lines. Void won't do a hell of a lot inside the Chronosphere. He'll just head back out. Overgrowth comes out, and Ketchik looking for the Requiem, but the Ravage has already flown. Venomancer will secure the kill onto Bristleback, but down goes the Shadow Fiend instead. It's a 1-for-1 trade, and Arrow coming out pretty far ahead. Invasion headed for the base, and now Snow, he's on the run. Throws out the Venomous Gale, connects onto Mosin. Meatball flying down, might be enough to hedge him out. Well, won't secure the kill, but oh, buyback from the Shadow Shaman now. He'll go in onto the Enchantress, secures the kill there. Looking for a kill onto DDZ, but Ghostwalk comes out.
And fine, probably next to nothing. Unless they go all the way mid lane, and that's where Kachik could be in a vulnerable position. They've even got the Observer, which gives them great vision right now, so.
Smoke expires, but they'll see the Shadow Fiend farming up the neutrals here. He gets Hex to start things off. No BKB for you, Mr. Shadow Fiend. He will fall. Now FCZ trying to save his Shadow Fiend buddy. He'll be in some trouble. He pops the relocate, but they should be able to bring him down. Tornado flies through as well, but doesn't even.
You know, Lafferty, the Bristleback. You just can't really go on it.
Yep, here we go. Chronosphere to start things off. Johnny gets dropped. Shadow Fiend on the outside of the sphere doing a lot of damage, but the Void goes down, as does the Venomancer from the DDZ on the outside. And it's looking good for Arrow as they continue to press forward. The Wrath of Wards come down onto the ground, and now Ketchik without a BKB. He will get chased down. He has evasion, but it's just not enough to keep him alive. Or is it to relocate? Takes him back to the well. It's a 1-for-3 trade. Next.